Hello dear friends, today I'm going to show you how I attach the legs to the bodies of my dolls. This is the most frequently asked questions that I get from you, and I'm happy that our first video is dedicated to this technique. It's very simple, it's very easy, so now I'm going to comment everything I'm doing, what I use, how I use it, and so on and so on. Sorry for my poor English, I'll do my best. So let's begin. Okay, let's do it. So first of all, what do I need is the head and the leg parts of the doll. These here are 3D printed, but I also do the same things for the clay part. Here are my larger scissors and my smaller scissors. The larger are for trimming the very big areas of long fur, and the smallest are for trimming like the head and small parts. Next, here are some clear Czech beads. I use them, they're just general, I don't know. The thread I usually take of the natural color, so I don't keep a stock of colored threads. The needles are also the bead needles. I use number 12 here. I always buy like several packs of these because these needles break very easily, but still I love to work with these because they are very comfortable to attach the legs for them. And the body parts here, the head, the neck, everything. You'll see how I do it. These are the basic patterns I use for basic dolls. The filling is just simple Cintapon, very soft, very fluffy. And the granulate, the steel granulate, which makes the body a little bit heavy, very nice heaviness. One more thing I'll be needing is this long forceps tweezers. I've been using them for years, they're very nice, very long, and they're ideal for filling the body with Cintapon and for turning the sewn parts out. I'll show you next time how I turn out the parts, and today I'm just filling the body with the tweezers. Well, first thing I'm doing, I take this round part, this is the head, just a sphere, we'll be doing. And I take the needle and thread and start making the pom-pom. I trim the detail and then I'll be tightening the thread. So at first I don't tighten the thread too much because I want this sphere to have even shape. So now you see how I come to the beginning of the part, and I'm spreading it out so the ball is of a nice round shape. Well, now I'm filling the ball with the Cintapon. The head must not be too soft and hollow, so I take a lot of the stuff, but it shouldn't show out too much. Let's see if the head fits. Now I'll take a head, and yes, it fits. It fits all right. So next I'll be just gluing it to the head. So I'm tightening. I'm making the knot here, and now I'll be fitting the head. My little scissors will be next to me all the time, because when I glue the head to this ball, I'll be cutting, trimming the fur. Okay, you see it fits all right. I'm just looking at it, just seeing that the fur is too long, and I'll have to cut it a little with these little scissors. So I take my super simple, just regular permanent glue, this cyanoacrylate, and I spread it all over at the edges of this head. The layer is very thin, and this tube can live for 1 month of my work. Well, for 3 weeks for sure. Now I'll just press the head to this fur ball for about 10 seconds because I don't want the head to go off the mask. So I have to make sure that it sits all right and it's glued all right. I'm still pressing, I'm still waiting because I don't want the head to go off the mask because it will be such a pain. I mean some things take time in this work, and now yes, it's okay, it's all right, we can go further and I'll take my super little scissors and I'll be trimming the head. I make a little speed up here because everything in my work takes time. Even if it's 15 seconds, it's time. And now you see how nicely these scissors cut the edges. I mean, they are really thin and they are comfy to work with. My every tool is comfy to work with because I've been using them for years. I've been making those for 10 years now. So everything I use is fine and okay, and I can recommend it to you. You can see a toothbrush because I always have one nice new toothbrush for my dolls. I've been combing and brushing my dolls since forever with the toothbrushes like Barbies and ball jointed dolls and my own dolls. Toothbrush is the best. I'm trimming the head a little bit more because here are the long hairs here and there. And now we're ready to go to the next part. The toothbrush is very nice for painting the body parts, the fabric parts, but I'll show you how I do it next time, and now some more, even more trimming, and we can take all this rubbish and go to the next part, which is next. Here again, I do all the same things to show the neck that I have just done with the head part. The neck is not stuffed too tightly. This is not a full sphere. Now I press the neck to the head so it won't run away, and I start sewing, attaching one to another. I think it's important for the doll to have a neck part. I make the neck even for the giraffe dolls. I don't know, I've been making those for years and they all need this little neck ball because otherwise they look just ridiculous and I don't like the style of that.
First, I take two body parts and start sewing with a simple back stitch. Don't forget to make the seam lines on the both body parts. This will help you sew nice and accurate. I use the pen for this pattern, but I recommend you to use a simple pencil or just light paint like acrylic. There's a big hole, so I can easily turn the body out, and I don't need my long tweezers here. But for the little dolls, like 4 cm high, I always use the tweezers because it's impossible to turn out the body otherwise. Well. The seam line I will need to clean up with a thick needle. I'll need to make the fur come out of the seam line. Now I'll show you my lazy way I used to stuff the dolls. I love the easy ways, and almost all the things I do are just one big lazy way. I take the needle coil and place my hand around it as a funnel. Next, I take the bottle with granulate and start pouring it into the body. Be careful and don't spill the granulate, because this will be so very hard to clean up all these little balls. I fill the dough for about one half of the body, because I like it when the dough is a little bit heavy. And I'll be stuffing the doll with a synth pawn using that tweezers I have. I mentioned it before that the synth pawn will make it easier for the needle to go through the body. The body is also filled not too tightly, and I'll string the neck hole so nothing falls out of the body and it looks neat in overall. Same movements as for the head and the neck, like this making little pom-pom and stringing the fabric on the needle. Next thing will be attaching the head to the body, just like we've been sewing the head to the neck. Just all the same things. So, as I said before, all this stuff I learned when I was little kid, and we've been making little stuffed animals at school.
Thank you.
Once the head is attached to the body, I can start making the tail. I just shape my tin foil into the shape of the platypus tail, which is very similar to the beaver's tail, by the way. Then I'm placing the tin foil piece into the fur tail part. And I start sewing the edges of the fabric with the hidden stitch, just to sew them together. After that, I attach the tail to the back of the body. The tails are very nifty to keep the doll sit well and well. Now we have attached the neck to the head and the neck to the body. So the sewing part is over. Also we have attached the tail to the back of the body. Well, what I have to say, we don't have to sew anymore. And all the seam lines that were to made are made. And now it's very important part. It's very boring. It's very long and time taking and painful. At least my back pains a lot after I do this, but if you want your doll to look lovely and nice and good, you have to do it. I mean, you have to clean up these seam lines. I take a very long, it not necessarily must be a long one, but I have just this, my long thick needle, and start cleaning up the seam lines. Try to bring out these pieces of the fur that stuck in between the edges of the fabric with this needle. You have a lot of work here to do, because over where we've attaching the parts, there are these bits of fur here and there under the tail and under the neck, but you should do this, trust me, you won't regret. finally, we can attach the legs. For the first upper leg, I do the following. I place the leg where I want it to be and get the needle and thread through it. Next, I add the bead and the needle. After that, goes back through the leg all the way to the edge of the back, where the shoulder blade of this animal must be. Now for the second upper leg, I do exactly the same and I use the same thread. It's more comfortable to work with one same thread for the pair of upper legs or the lower legs, whatever. And the basic movements for attaching the lower legs are just the same as for the upper legs. As you can see, it's really very simple, and I honestly hope that this will be useful for so many of you who have been asking me to make a tutorial how to attach legs. Here it is. There's nothing much to say, because this platypus doll is very basic. It has very little difficult parts, and the most valuable in this doll is not the work I'm doing to paint or attach it, but the look it has, how it's cute and lovely, and everybody likes platypus. That's all. And the legs, this is very easy. And once you make several dolls, you learn the technique, and it's easy for you to make some other animals and give them these legs. Now we have finished the legs, and we just do the same as we've been doing when cleaning up the seam lines, just brushing the fur around the legs a little bit more, and maybe trimming a little bit more, and making the doll sit, and looking if the balance is okay. If not, I just use my fingers to balance it a little bit better. And well, as I have said it several times today, it's very basic, it's very easy to do, to make a doll. So it's finished, it's done. You can give it something around its neck, or some color, or some, I don't know, a bell. I love bells, so bells, they sound nicely. And that's it, we're done. So friends, thank you so much for your attention, for your patience with my very bad English. I know it's terrible, and I'm really grateful if you've watched this video, and I hope it's been helpful. And if you have any questions on how I attach the legs or anything else, please feel free to send these questions to me. I'll do my best to answer, to make new videos for you. Thank you, and see you next time.